Shalom, everybody. Rabbi Edelstein here with a special and unexpected edition of Rabbi Ian 3 for the last day of Chanukah. Brought to you, as always, by MEOR DC. Find us on Facebook at MEOR DC or MEOR.org, our national website. Learn about our programs. The eighth day of Chanukah, and I'm filming this in a virtually empty district house on the campus of GW, and there's a Yiddish word, geschmack. It's a beautiful, delightful experience to be in an almost empty district house. A miracle, you might say. You can get coffees and Pete's and Starbucks without waiting in line. Now, don't get me wrong, it's much more delightful to have Jewish students here to interact with and share Jewish wisdom with them, but there's a certain special atmosphere to the calmness of district house right now. Perfect for me to have a conversation with you on the eighth day of Chanukah. Very underappreciated day, because we've already been there, done that. We've lit the menorah. We've had the chocolate gelt or given that away. We've had jelly donuts. You know, you're kind of tired, ready to move on. But don't think that way, neither today nor in general. What do I mean? Well, first of all, the great sages tell us the last day of Chanukah is the most elevated and most spiritual. We lit 8 candles last night. The greatest illumination, the greatest or, the greatest light of all is today. And the eighth day was the ultimate magnification of the miracle. When the Jewish people took control of the temple, that flask of oil that was only supposed to last one day lasted 8 days. The pinnacle of the miracle is today, the last day of Chanukah. So in the last hours of this last day, we should stop and think about the days past, about what we want to take with us internally into the post-Chanukah days to come. I hope we had, myself included, some illumination, some sense of the specialness of being Jewish, of the Jewish soul. By the way, the candle, the light, the ner is representative of the Jewish soul and of Jewish wisdom, and how even in the darkest times that can't be extinguished. And even if it's just one person, one family, and it was one family that started the resistance against the Syrian Greeks, even one person or one family that yearns for purity and for connecting to that Jewish spark inside, even if that's there, the rest will follow eventually with God's help. That's a message of Chanukah. The specialness of the Jewish soul, the specialness of Torah wisdom, the elevating light of the Torah in an often dark world. So much to think about as we leave Chanukah, but still a few hours to feel a little bit of that illumination and inspiration. Chanukah means dedication, because the Jews rededicated the Holy Temple to the service of God after it had been desecrated by the Greeks. Chinuch also means education. A day to re-educate, rededicate ourselves to our Judaism before we say goodbye to Chanukah for this year. Very special holiday, very special day, the eighth day of Chanukah. The Greeks, the Syrian Greeks, tried not to exterminate us as a people. They tried to take us away from the Torah and from the mitzvot. That was the essence of the threat at the time of Chanukah, and that should be the essence of what we think about in our rededication to the beauty of our Judaism, of our commandments, particularly of Torah study, Shabbat. The Greeks also went after circumcision. Now, circumcision, what does it represent? It represents that we elevate and sanctify the physical. On the very body of a Jewish man, that message is engraved, if you will, to elevate and sanctify the physical so that the soul, the Jewish soul, can shine forth to be a light to the nations. Have a wonderful eighth day of Chanukah.